Good morning, Hawk Nation, and welcome to another edition of Hawk Talk. I am your host, Bryce Johnson. Today, I am joined by Kendi Barnard, a forward on the Hawks women's basketball team. Kendi, how are you today?
Good, how are you?
I am doing fantastic. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous day here in Bristol. Absolutely fantastic. I almost feel bad for being in the studio today. It's so nice out. So we'll jump right into it here, and first question, what drew you to come and play basketball for the Hawks?
Honestly, the team chemistry, like when I did my overnight here, instantly you could see it. Everyone was engaging with me, interested in what I had to say, and everyone was really welcoming, so that was like the first thing that drew me. And when I first talked to Coach Thompson, our ideals about basketball kind of just aligned, and it just worked out. And I walked around campus, I was like, oh my God, I have to go here, it's so pretty.
Yeah, the views are tough to beat, in my opinion. And you also came down to Bristol to play for the Hawks alongside Lizzy Stevenson now, for those who don't know. You two were high school teammates, and now you're both sophomores here at Roger Williams, right? And I assume you two are close.
Yes.
So did being able to come and continue playing with Lizzy influence your decision to come and play for the Hawks?
Honestly, we kind of were both doing our own thing with recruiting, but with AAU and a lot of my high school teammates, like, we were talking to the same coaches, so typically I was talking to, like, three of the same coaches as five of my friends. So we kind of were doing our own thing, and then one day she just told me that she was committing here, and I was like, oh my God, like, I literally just talked to the coach. I'm really interested in it. And I didn't want to step on her toes, but she was so welcoming. She's like, yes, of course, like, do what you want to do, and I'm glad we both made the decision to come here.
Seems to have worked out pretty well for you guys.
Yeah.
And describe your relationship with Lizzy, given that you two played together for so long.
We honestly have been best friends since, like, fifth grade. We played on the same basketball team together since second grade. We had our own friends in high school, like, our own friend groups, but every time it was basketball season, we were right there with each other, always going to games together, practices, and it's just the same as it is here. We literally live across the hall from each other, so it's really nice. We're still close.
You guys, like, telepathic on the court, you know, look passes all day long?
We always say we can read each other so well, and especially, like, in basketball, we know what the other person's going to do, so good chemistry.
That's fantastic. And you are in your second year here in Bristol, one normal, regular season, and now one crazy one due to COVID. From your perspective, how has your team's preparation differed this year from last?
It's obviously been a lot different. Everything's been affected from COVID, and that was the first big thing we saw was we didn't have our, like, we usually play pickup all throughout the spring, didn't have that. Over the summer, we did some, like, online, like, workouts with each other via Zoom. It was so funny, like, we're all standing in our bedrooms, like, punching, doing, like, jabs. It's so funny. So I think the hardest part was just being away from each other, but also, like, keeping each other motivated, and we kind of were always on our toes. We weren't sure whether we were going to have games or not. Fortunately, we are going to be, but it was kind of just keeping each other and yourself motivated while being apart. That's the biggest difference.
Yeah, I'm going to be honest. I have missed pickup basketball a lot.
Yeah, so fun.
It's so much fun. And yeah, I've missed it. But I'm happy to have sports back in general because, yeah, I like sports. And you had a really strong freshman year last year, especially defensively and on the glass. You were second on the Hawks in rebounding, third in steals, and led not only the team but the Commonwealth Coast Conference in blocks. What is it that you think makes you so strong in those aspects of the game?
Honestly, I just think it's because I'm really tall and long. That's obviously the first reason, but I also played volleyball for a while, and I remember, like, after my fall season of volleyball, I'd go into my fall AAU season, and I'd be, like, smacking girls left and right. My coach is screaming at me. I'm like, I'm used to hitting the ball in volleyball. But honestly, I've just always been, like, a defensive-minded player, been a little bit timid on the offensive end. So when I was younger, I just, like, decided to develop defense, and that's what I felt most confident in.
What would you prefer to have, a tough contested rebound or just swat? Well, I guess that's an easy question. Swat one to the fifth row.
I'd rather swat one. It's so exhilarating. It's the best feeling.
It's pretty great. It's pretty great. And you set the program record for blocks in a single game last year against the University of New England. What did setting this record mean to you so early in your career?
Honestly, my mom is more big on the stats than I am. She would, like, tell me everything. She'd be like, you're this for this. And my grandfather is really into it. But it was just nice to see the support that I got, and it felt, like, validating for me that what I was doing on and off the court was, like, kind of showing off because people were really appreciating me. But honestly, everything's a team, like, our game's a team sport, and I wouldn't have gotten half those blocks if something else hadn't have happened in the game. So it's kind of all up to them in trusting me to play defense well.
Good, good. So let's look forward. You are admittedly in a tricky spot because your freshman year kind of got cut short, you know, academically, and now your sophomore year has basically been wiped out. But you've undoubtedly been working on your game. Any new wrinkles to the game that we can expect from Kendi Barnard for next season or games this spring?
I'm going to be a three-point shooter.
All right, nice.
I'm just kidding. If anyone on my team, like, listens to this, they're going to die laughing. I'm not really a three-point shooter, but kind of at this stage in, like, my college career, I kind of just want to solidify what I'm confident in and what I know I can do, just getting shots up at the gym, like, making sure I have a consistent shot and containing, like, on defense, making sure I keep that up.
Let's put it this way. You had me convinced that you're going to be a three-point shooter.
Oh, we'll see.
That being said, I'm still the
I'll
new guy.
Them. I don't know if I'll make that.
Hey, you miss 100% of the shots you don't
yes,
take, right?
Michael Jordan.
Yes. So, and for someone like myself, like I just said, who hasn't had the opportunity of seeing your team play, how would you describe your team's style of play out on the court?
Well, as I've said before, my team, like, we have such good chemistry on and off the court. You'll see us literally having dinner with each other at Commons, like a date. Just all of us around campus will say hi to each other. We're all really close, which makes our chemistry on the court even better. Like, we know each other very well, and we also have trust and confidence in each other. And we all know our roles really well, which is what's important for our team, because we don't have one star. Everyone has to do what they have to do. So kind of when you're watching, it's just like one cohesive unit. And also the energy at our games is insane. Like, in volleyball, you have to cheer for everything, but literally in basketball, with our team, it's the same thing. If someone does one thing on the court, you'll see the bench, everyone's up on their feet, like, cheering. We huddle after everything. Like, it's just, it's good energy in the gym.
Yeah, having that good team energy is always just a better team environment in general, in my opinion. So that's fantastic. And off the court, you are studying psychology, right?
Yes.
What made you want to study that, and what do you want to do with that in the future?
Well, my sister studied psychology, and she got her master's, and she's now a family therapist. So I kind of saw that path, and I really was interested in it. Took a few classes in high school, loved it, and I always, like, wanted to be that friend that was, like, approachable, and I felt like my friends always did approach me with issues or just to talk. So I kind of want to take that and maybe take a therapy route, or maybe like a student guidance counselor or something like that.
That's cool.
Yeah.
I'll admit, when I was going through my undergrad, I took one, you know, intro to psychology class thinking, oh yeah, it's going to be, this will be interesting. It was the worst class. You know, I got the lowest grade I've gotten in any class
really?
In my college career. And I was like a really great student, you know, A's, B's, you know, Dean's List, all that jazz. This class just, I couldn't do it. It was literally the one class that I studied like diligently for the exams, and I still got like a C, and I was like, all right, well, I'm happy with that. It's fine.
It is hard. It's a lot of vocab and memorizing.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm so interested in it, so like those are my classes that I usually do the best in, and I feel like they're the easiest for me.
The thing that I found most difficult when I was going through that class is there were a lot of like similar terms. It was the intro class. It was like similar terms with different meanings.
Yeah.
And so I was getting those confused all the time, and I was, well, that's why I don't do psychology. That's why I do media, right? Now, describe a day in the life of Kendi Barnard.
Honestly, it's not that exciting. I usually wake up, have class in the morning. Me and my roommate luckily have the same class schedule, so we don't wake each other up, even though I'm like the deepest sleeper, so she probably would never wake me up. And then I'll make breakfast, usually go to Lower Commons for lunch, either go to the gym with Lizzy, or if we have practice, go there. And then do homework, or me, Lizzy, and her roommate Riley have been watching this old show on YouTube called Whodunit. It's a mystery show, so we've been really into that late night. Definitely TikTok at night.
Okay, nice.
Have to.
It is a big trend these days.
Yes,
so
it's addicting.
Yeah, kind of. I find myself like right when I'm about to go to bed, I hop on TikTok. Next thing I know, it's an hour and a half later. Yep. I'm like, well,
so bad.
That's unfortunate. All right, so we got some rapid fire questions for you. You ready?
Yep.
Favorite basketball player of all time?
Michael Jordan.
Okay, that's a good one. I'm a huge Breonna Stewart fan because I'm from Connecticut, so
yeah.
UConn, baby.
All my teammates love her.
Yes. Favorite college pastime?
This isn't really a college pastime, but I guess it is for Roger Williams. Just going to Commons after, like, a practice and then seeing all the other athletes, like, mm-hmm. walk in sweaty with their parkas on. That's, like, the funniest thing ever. We always say, like, we're like a gang, all of us with our parkas on. So funny.
It's not just a Roger Williams thing. It's a, you know,
yeah,
college
sure.
thing in general. Yeah. The schools with a lot of athletes, you know, like my undergrad, you know, usually you'd walk in, just the entire baseball team would be taking up 1/3 of the cafeteria, and it would be like,
I know.
Well, I guess I'm not sitting there.
It's funny.
Favorite winter activity besides playing basketball?
I'm from New Hampshire, and I don't ski or snowboard, surprisingly. But I love tubing, sledding, and snowmobiling. That's really it.
That's good. That's good.
I don't like the winter that much.
I'm going to be honest, I'm not a huge winter guy either.
Yeah.
No. Much rather be in the summer because there's so much more to do. Go-to breakfast.
Sunset Cafe in downtown Bristol or Bristol Bagel, definitely. I don't know if you've been to either, but you should go.
I have not yet, but I will put them on the list.
Yes.
I have a running list of all the restaurants I have to go to in the Bristol and Southern Rhode Island area. And, well, I guess those will have to get moved to the top because when I do get up for breakfast, usually I go out.
Yes.
And finally, what is your pregame pump-up music?
Me and Lizzy actually just recently found our new pump-up song. It's Take On Me. You probably know that song.
Yep.
We were listening to it in the car, and we were just like, yeah, this is good. also, Kanye West, I love his music, pumps me up. Or I don't know if you've heard of the Big Booty remixes.
Those are fantastic.
Yes.
I love those.
They're such good pump-up songs.
Oh, they're so fantastic.
Yeah.
My favorite is number 17, I think.
Yes.
17 is really good.
The new one just came out.
Ooh, very nice. Yes. Oh, a couple weeks ago, yeah?
Yep.
Nice. Yeah, I have given that a listen, and it is very, very good. Final question. What is one thing that most people don't know about you?
I'm just going to say this because it's kind of like a running joke in my team and also with my friends. Everyone thinks I'm 6 feet tall, but I have to tell everyone I'm 5'10 and 3/4", but everyone like yells at me and they're like, no, you're 6 feet. Everyone always wants me to measure myself. So for everyone out there, I'm 5'10 and 3/4", not 6 feet tall.
We'll keep rounding it up though for
the
intimidation purposes.
On the basketball roster, I'm like 6'1". I'm like, okay, it's not even close.
It's all right. I always say that I'm like 5'9", 5'10", but I'm like 5'11" on a yeah. tall day, you know.
With shoes on.
Yeah, you know. Depends on how I'm feeling. Am I feeling tall or am I feeling shorter? Kendi Barnard, thank you so much for joining us.